गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, मायसेल्फ गणेश चंद्र भट्ट, फैकल्टी IHM कोलकाता। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ए न्यू टॉपिक ऑन फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट, दैट इज कैपिटल बजेटिंग। इन दिस टॉपिक वी विल कवर द मीनिंग, एग्जांपल्स, फीचर्स, स्टेप्स, नीड और इम्पोर्टेंस, लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। बाय द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन द लर्नर विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग एंड फीचर्स ऑफ कैपिटल बजेटिंग, नो द वेरियस स्टेप्स इन्वॉल्व्ड इन कैपिटल बजेटिंग, एंड फाइनली अंडरस्टैंड द इम्पोर्टेंस और नीड ऑफ कैपिटल बजेटिंग इन ए होटल। मीनिंग ऑफ कैपिटल बजेटिंग फर्स्ट। कैपिटल बजेटिंग कैन बी डिफाइंड एज द प्रोसेस ऑफ मेकिंग लार्ज इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ करेंट फंड्स ऑफ ए बिजनेस एंटरप्राइज मोस्ट एफिशियंटली इन द लॉन्ग टर्म एक्टिविटीज इन एंटिसिपेशन ऑफ सर्टेन एक्सपेक्टेड कैश बेनिफिट्स ओवर ए सीरीज ऑफ ईयर्स। इन दिस डेफिनेशन देर आर 5 हाईलाइटेड पॉइंट्स। इफ वी विल डिस्कस इन डिटेल अबाउट दीज 5 हाईलाइटेड पॉइंट्स, देन द मीनिंग ऑफ कैपिटल बजेटिंग कैन बी वेल अंडरस्टूड। फर्स्ट, लार्ज इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ करेंट फंड्स। इट मीन्स द फंड्स अवेलेबल टू ए बिजनेस आर इन्वेस्टेड एंड दिस इन्वेस्टमेंट इज मेड इन लार्ज अमाउंट। वन थिंग टू बी नोटेड हियर दैट द फंड्स अवेलेबल टू ए बिजनेस फर्म आर ऑलवेज लिमिटेड, देयरफोर इन्वेस्टमेंट शुड बी एज मिनिमम एज पॉसिबल बींग इट इज ए कॉस्ट टू द कंपनी। ऑलवेज इन्वेस्टमेंट इज द कॉस्ट टू द कंपनी। इन्वेस्टमेंट्स मेड आर ऑल्सो नोन एज कैश आउटफ्लोज, दैट मीन्स इन्वेस्टमेंट्स आर अदरवाइज नोन एज कैश आउटफ्लोज। सेकेंड पॉइंट, मोस्ट एफिशियंटली। इट मीन्स इन ए मोस्ट इफेक्टिव मैनर सो दैट द रिटर्न फ्रॉम द इन्वेस्टमेंट कैन बी मैक्सिमाइज्ड। पॉइंट नंबर 3, लॉन्ग टर्म एक्टिविटीज। इट मीन्स द लॉन्ग टर्म प्रोजेक्ट्स और द कैपिटल एसेट्स और द कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर्स। लॉन्ग टर्म एक्टिविटीज इंक्लूड एडिशन, डिस्पोजिशन, मॉडिफिकेशन एंड रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ फिक्स्ड एसेट्स। लेट्स एक्सप्लेन दीज टर्म्स। फर्स्ट, एडिशन। एडिशन ऑफ फिक्स्ड एसेट मीन्स एडिंग टू और एक्सपेंडिंग ए फिक्स्ड एसेट। सपोज ए बिजनेस हैज ए बिल्डिंग, इन एडिशन टू दैट इट रिक्वायर्स टू कंस्ट्रक्ट अनदर बिल्डिंग फॉर द यूज इन द बिजनेस। दिस इज कॉल्ड एडिशन टू द फिक्स्ड एसेट्स। नंबर 2, डिस्पोजिशन। डिस्पोजिशन ऑफ फिक्स्ड एसेट्स means the disposal or discarding of a fixed asset when it does not perform. Suppose a business has a machine which is not performing well and the business wants to dispose it off or discard it, so it will not be in further use of the business. This is called disposition of the fixed assets. 3, modification. Modification means modernization or mechanization of a process. For example, mechanization of the production process. When we mechanize the production process of our business, it increases the production capacity and also reduces the cost of production of the business. 4, replacement. Replacement of a fixed asset means substituting an old asset with a new one. Point number 4, expected cash benefits. It means the cash benefits or returns which will be received in future from the investment made. Cash benefits should be as maximum as possible. Cash benefits are also known as the cash inflows. Point 5. A series of years. A series of years means a number of years consecutively. Consecutively refers to one after another without interruption. Say, for 5 years continuously, for 7 years continuously, or for 10 years continuously, this is called a series of years. Now, an example for your better understanding what capital budgeting is. Suppose a project requires an initial investment of rupees 2 lakh. That means initially we have to invest rupees 2 lakh in the project. It yields, means it generates the annual cash inflows for its 5-year lifespan are 60,000 rupees in the first year, 80,000 rupees in the second year, 60,000 rupees again in the third year, 50,000 rupees in the fourth year, and 70,000 rupees in the fifth year. In this particular example, there are 3 columns made. Year, that is the first column, second, annual cash inflows, and third, cumulative cash inflows. Years are 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and the annual cash inflows as given in the example, rupees 60,000 in the first year, rupees 80,000 in the second year, rupees 60,000 in the third year, rupees 50,000 in the fourth year, and rupees 70,000 in the fifth year. Now, after putting the first column and second column values, the third column we have to calculate it. How? The cumulative cash inflows. How it is to be calculated? It is to be calculated by adding each and every year's annual cash inflows. In the first year, the annual cash inflow is 60,000. Therefore, the cumulative cash inflow will also be 60,000. In the second year, the annual cash inflow is 80,000. But the cumulative cash inflow will be how much? 60,000 first year plus 80,000 second year, it will be 1,40,000. In the third year, the cumulative cash inflows will be 1,40,000 plus 60,000, it will be 2 lakh. In the fourth year, again 50,000 will be added to get the fourth year cumulative cash inflow, that is 2,50,000. And in the fifth year, the 70,000 annual cash inflow will be added to 2,50,000, which will come to rupees 3,20,000. In this way, the cumulative cash inflows in the fifth year is coming 3,20,000. But we have made initially the investment of rupees 2 lakh. Suppose we say the initial investment amount of rupees 2 lakh is recovered fully in how many years? If you see the statement that we have made, the cumulative cash inflows, the third column, rupees 2 lakh is highlighted in red ink. That means that is the initial investment amount which is being recovered fully in how many years? In 3 years. Year 3 is recovering fully the initial investment amount of rupees 2 lakh. Thereafter, in the fourth year and fifth year, whatever cash flows we are receiving, that are our profits. After third year, in the fourth year, we are receiving how much of cash inflow? That is 50,000. That is our profit. In the fifth year, again we are receiving cash inflow of rupees 70,000. That is also our profit. After 3 years, whatever annual cash inflows we are receiving, that are our profits from the project. So from this example, I hope you have understood the meaning of capital budgeting. Thus, capital budgeting involves two things. First one, searching for the new and most profitable projects. Second, making an economic analysis to determine the profit potential. That means the profitability of each project. Capital budgeting is also known as long-term investment decision or capital expenditure decision or capital investment decision. These are the three other names of capital budgeting. Examples of capital budgeting. Some examples of capital budgeting decisions are, if we are going to acquire some fixed assets like land, building, plant, machinery, equipment, etc., then this proposal comes under the capital budgeting decision. Number two, proposal for addition or expansion of the fixed asset. If we are going to add to the existing fixed asset or we are going to expand the fixed asset, then the proposal comes under the capital budgeting decision. Three, proposal for improvement or alteration in the fixed assets. Suppose we are going to improve the existing fixed asset or we want to alter the fixed asset so that its capacity can be increased, then this proposal also comes under capital budgeting. Number four, proposal for modernization or mechanization of a process. Fifth, proposal for replacement of any fixed asset. If we want to replace our existing old fixed asset, then this proposal is also coming under capital budgeting. Sixth, proposal for introducing a new product in the market. Suppose the management decides to introduce a new product in the market, then the proposal also comes under capital budgeting. Now, the features of capital budgeting. Capital budgeting decisions have a number of features or characteristics. First, they involve the exchange of current funds for future benefits. That means the current funds available to a company are to be exchanged for some benefits to be received in future. Two, they have the effect of increasing the capacity, efficiency, and lifespan of a capital asset. Three, the funds are invested in non-flexible and long-term activities. Four, the future benefits are expected to be realized over a series of years. Five, the funds invested have a long-term and significant effect on the profitability of the business firm. Six, the funds are invested are of huge amount. Seven, they are irreversible decisions. Irreversible decisions means the decisions once taken cannot be changed. Now, the capital budgeting process. It means, what are the different steps involved in the capital budgeting? Capital budgeting process involves 4 steps. First, project generation. Second, project evaluation. Third, project selection. And fourth, project execution. In this way, there are 4 steps of capital budgeting. Let's explain in detail these steps. Step 1, project generation. That means identifying the projects. Project generation involves the identification of various projects for consideration. The proposals may include the following. First, introduction of a new product in the market. Second, expansion of the business by investing in plant and machinery. Third, mechanization of a process, that is to reduce the cost of production. Fourth, modernization of a process. And fifth, replacement of an old machinery or equipment. Step 2, project evaluation. That means the appraisal of the projects. This step includes the following 2. Number 1, estimation of benefits and costs of a project, that is to be measured in terms of cash flows. Benefits are called the cash inflows and costs are called the cash outflows. Second, selection of an appropriate criteria or method to judge the desirability, that means profitability of the project. Step 3, project selection, that means picking up the most profitable project. This step involves first ranking the projects according to their profitability, that means recognizing the fact that bigger benefits are preferable to the smaller ones and early benefits are preferable to the later ones. Second, screening the projects at multiple levels, but the final approval of the project generally rests on the top level management of the company. Step 4, project execution, that means planning for appropriation of funds in different projects. This step of capital budgeting includes first, planning for the appropriation of funds for different capital investment proposals selected, that is where to invest and how much to invest. Second, ensuring that the funds are spent in accordance with the appropriations made. Now, need or importance of capital budgeting, or you may say significance of capital budgeting. The need or importance of capital budgeting arises mainly due to the following points. First, exchange of current funds for future benefits. Second, large investment of funds. Third, investment in long-term activities. Fourth, realization of benefits over a series of years. Fifth, long-term effect on profitability. Sixth, effect on increasing the capacity of a capital asset. Seventh, irreversible decisions. And the 8th, national importance. When we explain all these 8 points of importance of capital budgeting, then the importance or the significance of capital budgeting in a business firm can be well understood. First, exchange of current funds for future benefits. Capital budgeting decisions involve the exchange of current funds for future benefits. It means the investment of funds made today will give you some benefits tomorrow. That means investment of funds to be made today and the benefits are to be received in future years. Hence, the necessity of capital budgeting arises in a business concern. Number two, large investment of funds. The funds available to a business concern is always limited. The funds to be invested in capital assets are of huge amount. Hence, it is very important for the business concern to plan and control its capital expenditures. Three, investment in long-term activities. The funds are invested in non-flexible and long-term activities. And the long-term activities include addition, disposition, modification, and replacement of fixed assets. All these points, all these terms we have already explained earlier. The long-term commitment of funds increases the financial risk involved in the investment decisions. Greater the risk involved, greater will be the need for careful planning of capital expenditures. Fourth, realization of benefits over a series of years. The future benefits are expected to be realized over a series of years, that is, over a number of years consecutively, say for the next 5 years or for next 10 years continuously. Future is always uncertain and inaccurate. Therefore, utmost care should be taken while predicting the future benefits. Hence, capital budgeting in a business form is very important. Fifth, long-term effect on profitability. The funds invested in capital assets have a long-term and significant effect on the profitability of a business concern. Not only the present earnings of the business firm are affected by the capital budgeting decisions, but also the profitability and future growth of the firm depends upon the investment decisions taken today. An unwise decision may prove disastrous to the business concern. Hence, capital budgeting is important to avoid any over investment or under investment in the long term assets. Six, effect of increasing the capacity of a capital asset. Means capital budgeting decisions have the effect of increasing the capacity, efficiency and lifespan of a capital asset. For example, a major repair and renovation work involving huge amount may increase the capacity and lifespan of a building. Therefore, capital budgeting decision is very needed in an organization. 7. Irreversible decisions. The capital expenditure decisions are of irreversible nature. Once such a decision is taken, it becomes very difficult to reverse that decision without incurring heavy losses. For example, if a new product is introduced in the market and subsequently it is proved that the introduction of such product was a wrong decision taken by the management of the company being unprofitable, then the company may drop out this product from the market, incurring huge losses. Therefore, capital budgeting decisions of a business firm should be taken very carefully. 8. National importance. Capital investment decisions are of national importance because they determine the employment, economic activities, and economic growth of a nation. Sum up the key points of the lesson are: first, capital budgeting is the long-term investment decision of a business enterprise. Number 2, it involves the exchange of current funds for future benefits. Number 3, the investments are done in the long-term or fixed assets. 4, it involves high financial risk to be borne by the company. 5, the funds invested are of huge amount. 6, the future benefits are expected to be realized over a series of years. 7, the funds invested have a long term and significant effect on the profitability of the firm. Capital budgeting decisions are of irreversible nature. 8, the decisions determine the employment, economic activities, and economic growth of a nation. Now, this is the exercise for you, given as homework to be done. Question number 1, define capital budgeting with some examples. List out the features of capital budgeting. In this question, you will have to give the complete definition of capital budgeting. Also, you will have to give the examples. Then you will have to list out all the features that we have already discussed in our lesson of capital budgeting. Question number 2, discuss the various steps involved in the capital budgeting process in detail. Here you will have to discuss all the 4 steps of capital budgeting. What are those? First, project generation. Second, project evaluation. Third, project selection. And fourth, project execution. All these 4 steps are to be discussed in detail. Question number 3, why is capital budgeting needed in a hotel? That means, what is the importance of capital budgeting? Here, in this question, you will have to explain all the 8 points that we have already discussed in our lesson today. Here are some reference books for you that I suggest. Along with the lesson held today, you may also refer these books for your clear understanding and for your broad knowledge. Hope you have enjoyed the session today. In the next session, we will discuss the various methods of capital budgeting, and that too only the traditional methods. Thank you very much.